of the game, which was the fourth for Forsberg, came in the dying seconds. That was a power play goal. And now we've got an altercation between the benches. And again, you've got a situation where teams get run out of the building and they want to try to do something about it, one way or the other. So Voracek getting tied up with Tanner Jeannot.
Well, Columbus plays a physical style of game, and so do the Predators. This game hasn't really taken on that type of a feel.
Yeah.
And it's rushed. Oh, they're going.
Jeannot doesn't mind. We'll go with Gavin Bayreuther. And down they go. Bayreuther was determined to just get something going here.
Yeah, I think you could see that kind of building. They were tangled up already. A little bit of a scrum, so they'll each get 5 minutes tacked onto their penalty totals there. Not much of a fight. But as you mentioned, Bayreuther just trying to spark something and from his group.
So Bayreuther, the 27-year-old, in the box. See how they score all. They're having a little huddle.
Watch here, top of your screen. Yakov Trenin's going to... That wasn't much there, so I'm not sure. They're just looking for a reason. A reason to spark something here.
So there is Gavrikov taking down Jeannot. So you see the activities going on that led up to everything.
Just a little hit there, and eventually everybody joined the fun, and Yakov Trenin, the big goal tonight, courtesy of a beautiful saucer pass from Colton Sissons. The Herdlines had a strong game tonight.
No question about it. That's another very good sign.
Yep.
Really, all four lines have contributed. Now, John Hines asking the referees, fill me in here, Furman South over there talking. John Hines not satisfied with the initial answer. Said, timeout. Can I have another word with you? So just 40 seconds in to the third period. If you joined us late, Nashville came out of the gate flying. Forsberg got the night started with his seventh of the season at 4:56. Then the Predators scored two goals in 9 seconds. Trenin and then Forsberg's second. Then late in the second period, Nashville tacked on two more after absorbing a lot of heat from the Blue Jackets. They had a lot of shots in the second period. They had a goal waved off for an offside challenge. And then Forsberg got his third and fourth of the night at 15:26 and then 19:54.
Yeah, they were definitely pushing. The Blue Jackets put up 14 shots in the second period, and yet Hines isn't... Well, it looks like on the score clock right now that the Blue Jackets have the extra penalty, but
the Predators have five skaters on the ice. John Hines said it has to be five on five.